Solve. 2x squared minus 24x plus 8 equals 0. We're going to solve this quadratic equation by completing the square. And the first thing you want to do when you're completing the square is to make this coefficient 1. So we'll do that by dividing by this leading coefficient. So in this case, the coefficient is 2. So divide everything by 2, and then you'll get x squared minus 12x. I'm going to leave a big space here, and I'll tell you why in just a bit, plus 4, 8 divided by 2 is 4, equals 0. Okay, the reason I left that big space is because when you are completing the square, you're going to have this form, x squared plus bx, leave a big space, plus c equals 0. So our b in this case, let's write this out right now just to be clear. Our b equals negative 12. So it's okay that we have a plus here to minus here. It's just like saying plus negative 12. B is negative 12. What we're going to fill in this space here is plus b over 2 quantity squared. Okay, and because you added it on one side, that completes the square. And because you added it on one side, you've got to add it on the other. So I better write that in so I don't forget. B over 2 quantity squared. Okay, let's put that in right here. Put a line here so we can keep this straight. Let's keep this separated. Our B over 2 quantity squared. B over 2 quantity squared. Ours equals negative 12 over 2 quantity squared, which equals negative 6 quantity squared. Negative times a negative is a positive 36. So I'm going to add 36. And I'm going to put this in parentheses so it's kind of blocked off. I added 36 to this side. I have to add 36 to the right-hand side as well. Okay, we've added 36 to each side. I've completed this square. We're going to deal with this 4 in just a minute. Okay, this factored form. The factored form, then, is going to be x plus b over 2 quantity squared, and then dot, dot, dot. All right, I'll fill that in. We've got a bunch of stuff going on there. Remember that our b over 2 is negative 6, so it's okay that I'm saying plus here. So plus a negative 6 is like saying minus 6, and that's what I'll write here. So I will write x minus 6 quantity squared plus 4 equals 36. Now, I'm sure some of you feel very comfortable with subtracting that 4 on that step, and go ahead and do that, but I just want to keep it clear, take it step by step. I'll subtract the 4 here, and that'll leave us with this x minus 6 quantity squared equals 32. 36 minus 4 is 32. Okay, we've taken the proper steps to complete the square. You might want to review that if you're not clear on it. You can rewind and review that. But now, this side equals this side, so we can take the square root of each side. And that's a legal function. Take the square root. We do have to remember that when you take the square root of something to solve an equation, you need to say plus or minus. All right, because the positive square root of 32 and the negative square root of 32 is the same as this side. Okay, the square root of something squared takes away that squared. So now we have x minus 6 equals plus or minus the square root of 32. Right? Square root of something squared just takes away that squared. This leaves two things. We have two solutions, and most of the time you will have two solutions for a quadratic equation. So I'm going to say two mini equations. All right, I'll set those up in a different color here. Let's use a purple just to delineate here. All right. X minus 6, that equals either positive square root of 32, or x minus 6 equals negative square root of 32. All right, let's bring that up. I'm going to bring that up here. So you could add 6 to each side and get x equals 6 plus the square root of 32, or x, in this case, add 6 to each side, and you get x equals 6 minus the square root of 32 because of that negative square root of 32. So those are our two solutions, 6 plus the square root of 32 and 6 minus the square root of 32. We should clean this up. We should simplify this radical, and let's just do that in another color real quickly. The square root of 32, to simplify, factor out a perfect square, so that equals the square root of 16 times the square root of 2, which equals 4 square roots of 2. Okay, so now we have these two solutions. So 4 square roots of 2 is what I'm going to write in instead of the square root of 32. All right, let's rewrite that. Our final solution, the two solutions, is 6 plus 4 square roots of 2, and the other solution is 6 minus 4, 6 minus 4 square roots of 2. Those are the two solutions to that quadratic equation.